Hi everyone, this session I am going to discuss about output equation for single phase core type transformer as well as output equation for single phase shell type transformer. What is the difference between single phase core type transformer and a shell type transformer? In core type transformer, the winding encircles the core, whereas in the shell type transformer, the core encircles the winding. What it means actually, in core type transformer, the winding will be the outermost part. Whereas in the shell type transformer, the core will be the outermost part. Now if you come to that core type transformer, the winding will be placed on the core, that is on the limb. So here if it is primary winding or LV winding, it will be divided into two parts. So half of the part will be on the one limb and another half of the part will be on the another limb. Similarly, the HV winding also placed like that. Half of HV over here, then half of HV over here. But in the shell type transformer, the winding will be placed on the center limb. So entire LV will be placed over here. Similarly, over that entire HV winding will be placed over there. Either it will be on the cylindrical type or sandwich pattern type. So this figure shows the cross sectional view of single phase core type transformer, and this shows the cross sectional view of single phase shell type transformer. What are the terms we will be using? VP, primary voltage in volts. VS, secondary voltage in volts. IP, primary current in ampere. IS, secondary current in ampere. TP, number of turns in primary winding. TS, number of turns in secondary winding. AP, cross sectional area of the primary conductor. AS, cross sectional area of the secondary conductor. DEL, current density in ampere per meter square. AT, ampere turns. What is AT? AT is nothing but IPTP. IPTP, IP into TP, or IS into TS, that will give the AT value. Similarly, what is DEL? DEL is nothing but IP by AP, current per area, or IS by AS. So DEL is IP by AP or IS by AS. AT is IPTP or ISTS. Then KW. KW is called a window space factor. What is window space factor? It is the ratio of conductor area in a window to the area of the window. So KW equal to AC by AW, conductor area in the window divided by area of the window. F, supply frequency in hertz. Phi m, maximum value of flux on the core in Weber. AC, conductor area in a single window. AC, conductor area in a single window. How to calculate that AC? AC can be calculated by using this formula. Number of turns passing through the window. How many number of turns passing through the window multiplied by conductor cross-sectional area. The conductor cross-sectional area. So we have to take only one window, AC. AC is for conductor area in a window, single window. So even though if you have multiple window in the transformer, we have to take only one window. So number of turns passing through the window into conductor cross-sectional area. So by using this formula, we can calculate the AC value, conductor area in a window. Now if you take single phase core type transformer, how to calculate AC? Number of turns passing through the window. So this is window, only one window is there. So how many number of turns passing through the window? All the LV windings are passing through. Similarly, all the HV windings are also passing through. So all primary windings are passing through the window. Similarly, all the secondary windings are passing through the window. Now if we come to the shell type transformer, here we got two windows. You take any one window. Now if I take this window, all primary windings are passing through as well as all secondary windings also passing through. Here HV LV mentioned. So all LV windings are passing through as well as all the HV windings are passing through. Or otherwise if you take this window also, all HV windings are passing through the window and all LV windings are passing through the window. So calculation, AC calculation, AC is nothing but TP, all primary turns into cross sectional area of the primary winding. At the same time, secondary winding also passing. So plus all secondary turns PS into cross sectional area of the secondary conductor. So AC is nothing but TPAP plus TSAS. Already we know what the current density formula. Delhi is nothing but IP by AP or IS by AS. So from that, what is AP? IP by del. Or what is AS? AS is nothing but IS by del. So we can substitute AP value IP by del, AS value IS by del. So now IPTP or TPIP will become AT. Similarly, TSIS will become AT. So AT by del, AT by del. So we'll get AC as 280 by del meter square. So already we know what is the window space factor. AC by AW, conductor area in a window divided by area of the window. From that, what is AC? AC is nothing but KW AW. So AC equal to KW AW. This is for general. For any transformer, AC is KW AW. Here, this is for the single phase transformer. No matter whether it is core type or shell type, what is AC? AC is 280 by del. So we will equate both. If we equate both, 280 by del equal to KW AW. From here, what is AT? AT is nothing but KW AW del by 2. This is for single phase core type transformer or single phase shell type transformer. The AT value is KW AW del by 2. Now, what is the output equation for single phase transformer? In general, Q equal to VP IP into 10 raised to minus 3. Or we can use Q equal to VS IS into 10 raised to minus 3. Anyone we can use, either primary value or secondary value. So Q is rating in KVA. So Q equal to VP IP into 10 raised to minus 3 or VS IS into 10 raised to minus 3. Here I consider the primary value. So Q equal to VP IP into 10 raised to minus 3 KVA. For maximum adjustment, I am multiplying by TP as well as I am dividing by TP. So the value remains same. So Q equal to VP by TP into TP. So the TP TP get cancelled, the value remains same only. So VP by TP into TP into IP into 10 raised to minus 3 KVA. So what is VP by TP? VP by TP is ET. IPTP, IPTP is AT. So Q equal to ET AT 10 raised to minus 3. So VPTP become AT, IPTP become AT, VPTP become ET, IPTP become AT. So ET AT into 10 raised to minus 3. So what is the ET value? ET value is 4.44 f/5m. What is AT value? Just now we calculated. What is the AT value? KW AW del by 2. So that we need to substitute over here. So ET is 4.44 f/5m. AT is KW AW del by 2. Now the denominator 2 we get cancels, then the numerator value become 2.22. instead of 4.44 it become 2.22. so Q equal to 2.22 f/5m KW AW del into 10 raised to minus 3 KVA. So this is the output equation for single phase core type transformer and same output equation for single phase shell type transformer. Here 5m, what is the 5m? 5m is the maximum value of flux, maximum value of flux available in the core. So instead of 5m we can use bm also, bm into ai. bm is flux density, ai is net iron area. So if we do that bm into ai, we can replace the 5m. 5m can be replaced with bm into ai. So this is the generalized equation for single phase core type or single phase shell type transformer. Q equal to 2.22 f/5m KW AW del into 10 raised to minus 3. In examination, if they ask you to write only the single phase core type transformer, then you need to draw only the core type figure. So you need not to draw the shell type figure. Similarly, in examination, if they ask shell type transformer, output equation for shell type transformer, you need to draw only the shell type transformer view, the sectional view, not the core type transformer. So that is the difference between the single phase core type transformer and the single phase shell type transformer. And the derivation remains same. I hope you got how to derive the output equation for single phase core type as well as single phase shell type transformer. If you have any doubt, you mail to me. My mail ID is sivaprian@gmail.com. For my old videos, you just check the link given in the below description. You can check my old videos. In that, I discussed about old EMF per turn, all EMD, electrical machine design aspects I discussed. So if you have any doubt, mail to me.